Students, we will discuss about the general principles of Wheatstone bridge. Now this is a special case. Now see this circuit here. There are four resistance, and out of these three we know the value of 3 and 1 is unknown. Let us say P, Q, R are the known values and S is the unknown value. B and D are connected by a galvanometer, and this is connected to a battery. Let us say I current is going through the circuit. So what happens here? It breaks into I1 and I2 here. So Wheatstone bridge is a special case where when you balance the bridge, this is called bridge. So when you balance the bridge, it is balanced in such a way that the current passing through the galvanometer is equal to 0. Then what happens? This line of wire has got no relevance now. So the path becomes AB, BC and AD, CD. So in that particular case, what happens is P, Q, R is known, S is unknown. We get a condition that P by R is equal to Q by S. So 3 are known here, so the fourth one can be found out. Now how do I do this means? You can know here that VB is equal to VD. Okay. And why VB is equal to VD? Because there is no current flowing through this wire. Because there is no current flowing through the wire, it means that the potential has to be equal, or the potential difference has to be 0. So VA minus VB is equal to VA minus VD. From here to here, the potential drop will be equal to potential drop between VA to D. So this current is I1, this resistance is P. So I1 into P is equal to I1 into P is equal to I2 into R. So potential difference can be obtained by V is equal to IR. If you arrange this equation, I1 by I2, you get R by P. You get R by P. Similarly, VB minus VC is equal to VD minus VC. VB minus VC is equal to VD minus VC. Here also, why it is equal? The same logic. There is no current flowing over here. So here also, if you arrange the equation, you get this kind of a situation that I1Q is equal to I2S. See the previous diagram. Here I1Q is equal to I2S. So if you arrange the equation, you get I1 by I2 is equal to S by Q. Earlier I1 by I2 was equal to, here I1 by I2 was equal to R by P. So when you equate these two, you get a situation that P by Q is equal to R by S. When this situation is arrived, we call that the bridge is balanced. And this type of bridge is called Wheatstone bridge because it was developed by a scientist called Wheatstone. Many problems are asked on these Wheatstone bridges. So this specific condition we have to remember.